Hey guys, you're looking at the brand new Salora Arya A1 Plus. We reviewed the Salora Arya Z2 last month and were quite impressed by it. This one is a more entry-level phone, a cheaper one costing about 5,500, and it's already available. And you can see it's a pretty compact but it's a small device, and on the back side you have some of the quick specs. There's a 4.5-inch small QHD IPS display and one glass solution with full lamination. Full lamination helps reducing reflections. You have Wi-Fi, MediaTek quad-core 1.3 GHz processor, and then 5 MP back, 2 MP front with flash, 1 GB RAM, 8 GB ROM, and of course microSD card supported up to 32 GB. USB OTG feature, you're gonna check that. Dual SIM both support 3G and 2000 mAh battery, which is quite usual. The MRP is 6290, but as I told you, it's selling for a max of 5500 Indian rupees. And on top of the box, as expected, we have the device. It's a beautiful device nonetheless. Even the Z2 was beautiful, and I love the Arya here. I think it's Devanagari, which is very, very cool. And then we'll go further inside, and you have the user manual. You have the almost maroon color matte finish back cover and the white finish back cover. So basically you, and this sort of black, so basically you have three colors, and then your 1 ampere wall charger, your earphones. I'm just gonna show you the earphones. They're not very premium class as you would expect an entry-level phone. Silver plated audio jack, call control, mic, but no volume control, and micro USB 2.0 port. So that's about it. So that's our device, the Arya A1 Plus, and it looks fairly decent and fits nicely into hand, courtesy the small size, relatively small size, 4.5 inch device. It's still larger than most of the iPhones out there. 4.5 inch, and you have one glass solution, very glossy screen, attracts a lot of fingerprints, small QHD display, 2 MP front camera, your earpiece, and then I don't see any sensors over there. Your hotkeys around here, volume rocker, mouthpiece, power button, micro USB 2.0 port, and 3.5 mm jack. 5 MP out of focus back camera, records HD, LED flash, Arya branding, and then your speaker grill out there. The center of the speaker grill has a bump so that it does not obstruct the sound coming out whenever you place this device on a flat surface, but we'll have to see how successful it is. The back, well, it's all plastic, does not look very rugged but decent enough. 2000 mAh battery, you have one micro SIM, one full SIM, both supports 3G, and then the micro SD card which supports up to 32 GB in addition to the already available 8 GB. The phone feels very plasticky, expectedly for the price. The back cover goes right into the body around here. I like the sides here, very nice matte aluminium finish, gives the device a premium feel. Overall, I like this device. I've always been an over 5-inch device user, so at times whenever this kind of cute device comes to me, I really like using them, and I've been using this for a while now. The A1 Plus runs on Android KitKat and has its own in-house UI on top. So you see the main app drawer out here. You also have the typical home screen setup of Android, and it based on the stock Android does not go too deep with customization. You have your notification bar, quick function toggle, but you see almost similar to the stock ROM. You can long press to bring in the recent apps, so no Google Now, double tap, nothing happens. That's where you can go to settings and wallpapers. You can also add your widgets. Coming back to the app drawer, you have pretty much the default Android apps. You also have some popular apps, Amazon's mainly because this guy's gonna is selling on Amazon.in exclusively. Also, we have some we have installed some games for testing out here. I'm gonna uninstall those. So Beach Buggy, Fruit Ninja, Dropbox, Asphalt 8, and Nova 3. I've downloaded those, but apart from that, other apps come pre-installed. You can see only two pages of app, and of which about half of them are Google Android apps, and then your tools like downloads and contacts and galleries, FM radio and stuff. So not many bloatware will like it, and it's pretty smooth actually. So I'm gonna go to the settings and show you how it looks, the usual connection settings, storage. So now it will be quite less because I have all the games installed, but you'll have a lot of space, over 4 GB of space. And remember, I could actually install on Nova 3 and Asphalt 8 and a lot of these games that actually require huge space. So despite of having only 8 GB of ROM, it actually could accommodate those games quite easily. So you have a lot of free spaces available, which means that it does not have very heavy skin plus no bloatware. Settings, then that's how your dialer looks like, and the messaging app, there you see the default Google keyboard, and it becomes much smoother in and easier to type in landscape mode. You have your camera. Yeah, it's not exactly smooth and lag free, I would say. Still good enough. A very usual Android, default Android, you know, UI. You have your shooting modes, your HDR modes, and the front camera, the front 2 MP camera, which looks quite decent to me. And then you have all this. You also have a zero shutter lag, which improves the response time significantly. However, it not actually truly shutter lag free. So you have your video recording and pause, you can stop it out there. We've checked out the image and video quality, they're just about okay. So if you have this phone as your second device, then it's fine, but if you have it as your primary device, your photos might not come all that good. They're okay, the saturation are fine. The biggest con is the details are missing. They're uploadable to Facebook and Twitter and such, but the details that I told you is missing under enough light. Under low light, all the details are missing even more. Similar is the case with the videos. They do not look very sharp, although no fuzziness. However, the color are renders quite naturally actually. And I'm gonna check out the music now. Good speaker output with good bass, good treble, and despite of the speakers being situated on the back side, it does not seem to be obstructing the sound coming on. Obstructing just a bit, but not significant. There you see. Here you can feel that thumpiness. Yes, like the bass out there. And go the video and play a video to see how it sounds, how the vocal sound mid-range. Oh, nice. Decent viewing angle. I like the surround sound. So overall, a pretty impressive sound output. It's good. I really like it. It's quite smooth, the user interface. I'll just at last check out the gallery. So it's again a typical stock Android like arrangement. You have all the albums and photos arranged in stack. You can go ahead, you can edit. That will also give you the default Android, you know, edit options. So Salora did not bring in much customization. The customization mainly extended to the peripheral level, to the icon faces and all, but inside it more or less remains the stock Android UI, which is a good thing because that customization is not very heavy. You get a lot of free space, plus you can see the user interface is quite smooth out here. Now I'm gonna do some gameplay testing. We'll start with Fruit Ninja and see how it plays. So just lagging just a bit, not much. My slashes are real time. It's lagging occasionally, but overall quite smooth. So the movie looks quite smooth, not skipping frames. Let's see how it runs. I like the water droplets, nice texture. Because it's a small screen, even a QHD, small QHD display is actually good enough. And it seems bright enough. It's not pixelating the texture much, although there is slight pixelation, slight blowing out of details, but not significant. You really have to look closely. But I'm liking the game response. Oh boy. There you go. Asphalt 8 and looks okay so far. Smooth. Very, very smooth. Absolute breeze. So Asphalt 8 is very, very smooth on this, the A1 Plus. We did some benchmark testing on the A1 Plus and you can see our HTML5 score out there, 448. And then let's see, that's the comparison. AnTuTu score is pretty low, 19,113 right at the bottom, and that's a browser score. Okay, your multi-core score below average, really similar is the case with Metal 10 3D Mark score 2113, which is much less than let's say that's it's actually the highest are over 10,000, so it's similar range. You have these devices which are pretty old ones. And that's about it really. So pretty average benchmark scores. So then, should you get the Salora Arya A1 Plus? Well, it costs 5500, which puts it right in the competition space of the Redmi 1S, which is still selling. But Xiaomi told us during the Redmi Note launch that they're gonna discontinue the Redmi 1S. But now that the Note is not selling, they would probably stop selling the Redmi 1S. So as long as that's there, Redmi 1S actually has better specs than the Arya A1 Plus. It also has a better camera, has a bigger screen, and also looks sturdier for about only 500 more. But this actually look more beautiful than the Redmi 1S. We did a comparison video, you can check that out. I like the look of this device more, and also this guy is more pocketable. If you're not looking for a particularly large device, a 5-inch device, but a decent good looking one and not very finicky about the camera, the Salora Arya A1 Plus actually makes a good case. But if you want the maximum of specs, the bang for the bucks, then Redmi 1S still wins. If you like this video, please hit the like button, ask anything related to this phone and we'll try to answer them all. And please subscribe to our channel for more such awesome content in future. Thank you.